me.
Let us pray. Father, we give you thanks because of the joy you give. You are the giver of every good gift. Marriage is your gift, and Leon and Lynette are gift to one another. Lord, may their joy abound as they unite in marriage, and may you be honored and glorified in all that we do and all that we say here this afternoon. May it be for their good, and for your glory and for the benefit of everyone who is attending. May you minister to each of us by your grace, according to your mercy, and the overflow of your love, and the proclamation of your truth. Impress it upon Leon, Lynette, and all of us. In the name of our Lord Jesus, amen.
Amen.
You may be seated. Who gives this woman to be married to this man?
Your mother and I do.
Family, friends, loved ones. We are here today to rejoice, to worship, and to witness. We are here in joy to worship God and to witness the joining together in marriage of Lynette Coe of in a few minutes, though. It's not that funny, people. Of Leon Coe and Lynette Wee. And at this time, Leon and Lynette would like to take the opportunity to give thanks and to honor their parents on this joyous occasion. In so doing, he was communicating the significance of marriage. He was also helping us to see the meaning of marriage. Even as marriage is a universal practice for the good of all people, its purpose is to point us to the relationship between God and his people, Christ and his church. For it is in that relationship that the joy never runs out. The union of husband and wife, heart, mind, body, and soul, is intended by God for their mutual benefit, joy, health, and comfort under all circumstances of adversity and prosperity, and within God's will and timing for the bearing of children and their being raised in the discipline and instruction of the Lord. Therefore, marriage is not to be entered into unadvisedly or lightly, but reverently, deliberately, soberly, in the fear of God, and in accordance with the purpose for which it has been ordained by God. Now, into this blessed union, Leon and Lynette now come to be joined. You are now going to ask you to declare your intent. Leon, will you take Lynette to be your wife? And will you be faithful to her, to love her, honor her, live with her, and cherish her, according to the commandments of God in holy marriage? Lynette, will you take Leon to be your husband? And will you be faithful to him, to love him, to honor him, live with him, and cherish him, according to the commandments of God in holy marriage?
I will.
Amen. Would you all now please rise? And let us sing together, All Creatures of Our God and King, which lyrics are found in your program after the scripture reading.
Thank you.
It is now time for our scripture reading through the service. Let us now give our attention to the reading of God's word.
The Old Testament scripture reading is taken from Genesis chapter 2, verses 21 to 25. So the Lord God caused the man to fall into a deep sleep, and while he was sleeping, he took one of the man's ribs and then closed up the place with flesh. And the Lord God made a woman from the rib he had taken out of the man, and he brought her to the man. The man said, "This is now bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman, for she was taken out of man. That is why a man leaves his father and mother and is united to his wife, and they become one flesh. Adam and his wife were both naked, and they felt no shame." This is the word of the Lord.
This is a reading of God's word from Romans 12. "Therefore I urge you, brothers, in view of God's mercy, to offer your bodies as living sacrifices, holy and pleasing to God. This is your spiritual act of worship. Do not conform to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Then you will be able to test and approve what God's will is, his good, pleasing, and perfect will. For by the grace given me, I say to every one of you, do not think of yourself more highly than you ought, but rather think of yourself with sober judgment, in accordance with the measure of faith God has given you. For just as we all have one body with many members, and each member does not all have the same function, so in Christ, we who are many form one body, and each member belongs to all the others. Love must be sincere. Hate what is evil. Cling to what is good. Be devoted to one another in brotherly love. Honor one another above yourselves. Never be lacking in zeal, but keep your spiritual fervor, serving the Lord. Be joyful in hope, patient in affliction, faithful in prayer. Share with God's people who are in need. Practice hospitality. This is the word of the Lord for all of us, and for you, Lynette Finneham. Thanks be to God."
Leon and Lynette now are going to have a little talk. The rest of you can listen in, since you don't really have anything else to do. Leon and Lynette, first of all, and I can't resist saying this, you look marvelous. Well, Lynette more so than you, and I really don't mind that. I mean, you look good, don't get me wrong. Very, very athletic. Lynette, you look radiant and beautiful and happy. This is a joyous occasion. This is a cause of celebration. It is right and good for us to rejoice and to celebrate this very significant day that is blessed by God and brings you two together. And the reason, and there's so many reasons to rejoice, but it's part of the impulse of our humanity. Because God says in heaven, one of the pictures he gives us of heaven is that of a wedding feast. Right? So basically, this is a preview of what will one day be for the entire universe. At the same time, as I know both of you know, because we've talked about it, life isn't always going to be like this day. You're not always going to be beautiful in each other's eyes. As a matter of fact, you're going to see some ugly things in one another. Every single thing that's wrong with you is going to be known to the other person. All of your flaws are going to be exposed and magnified. You will fail, and sometimes even miserably. Your ability to hurt one another is infinite. And the question before us today, this day, is this. Whether such ugliness, whether such failure, whether such sin is opposed to your marriage, whether it gets in the way of your marriage, or whether it is the purpose of your marriage. And the question, how can that be so? How can all that bad stuff be the purpose of your marriage? And to answer that question, I want us to go to our Genesis 2 reading. There it says that is why a man leaves his father and mother and is united to his wife, and they become one flesh. Most translations say, for this reason, a man leaves his father and mother, and they become one flesh. You leave and come together with the two becoming one. Isn't that nice? Isn't that beautiful? Two become one. Leon, all that you have, all that you are, is Lynette's. And Lynette, all that you have and all that you are is Leon's. But then there's all this stuff, this conflict, disagreement, and hurt, and sin, and you don't want all of that. You just want the good stuff, right? All of that gets in the way, and it keeps you from coming together because you're hurt, or maybe because it's your way of hurting, punishing the others who you turn away, instead of two becoming one. Over time, a dividing wall of hostility can build up. So you don't feel very onesie, you know, which is kind of good because then that might stop you from wearing onesies, but that's a whole other thing, so we don't know that. Anyway, but marriage makes the two one. For this reason, a man shall leave his father and mother and make the two become one flesh. But your lived experience can cause you to come apart so that you are not one whole, but a divided two. Then what will you do? What can you do? Well, as you know, as members of All Souls Community Church, we've been going through the New Testament letter to the Ephesians at our church over these past months. And in chapter 5 of that letter, the writer, the Apostle Paul, quotes this passage from Genesis 2. For this reason, a man shall leave his father and mother united to his wife, and the two will become one flesh. And then he continues, this is a profound mystery, but I'm talking about Christ and his church. The two of you becoming one is a picture of actually something greater, something more significant. It's based on the relationship between Jesus and his bride, the church. And your marriage is based on this ultimate marriage. For this reason, a man shall leave and be united to his wife. Where did Jesus leave in order to unite to his wife and become one with her? We sing about it in one of our songs at church. He left his father's throne above, so free, so infinite his grace. For this reason, a man, the God-man, Jesus Christ, shall leave his father and unite to his wife. Why did Jesus leave? Why did he come to unite to his wife? To bear her sins, her wrongs, her failures, her hurts. For this reason, to love her, to cleanse her, to forgive her, to purify her, so that the two could become one. All that she had, she gave to him, her sins. And all that he had, he gave to her, his perfect, radiant life. Leon and Lynette is the only way the two can become one, the free and infinite grace of Jesus. So you see, in that case, all the less than beautiful, the ugly, the sinful, the hurtful, that your marriage is going to reveal isn't opposed to your marriage. And when you embrace that reason fully, then your marriage will begin to resemble the ultimate marriage between Christ and his church. First, you need to know that you are a part of that marriage, of that great marriage, that you are united to Jesus, each of you, within that marriage as he has lavished and lavishes infinite love, mercy, and grace upon you, and then grants you the privilege of being like him. It's only when you give away that grace in your marriage that you get to experience it and know it, that it's real for you personally. And you will have many opportunities to do so in your marriage. They will come, and they will come, and you will need the free and infinite grace of Jesus. Now, as much as you have in common in living this out, you receive grace and love from him, and you give it away over and over, there are also distinct roles for you to play in your marriage to live out. Leon as head, you are to be Christ. You are to lead in the way of Christ. And in all the ways I've already described Jesus doing, you are to love Lynette and lay down for her your life over and over and over again. It is your privilege. For this reason, God has brought you together. And Lynette, you have the privilege of submitting to Leon as the church does to Christ. In so doing, you are actually submitting to Jesus, the perfect husband, so that when Leon fails to lead and fails to love as he will, you forgive and love him as you have been loved and forgiven. And you continue to trust Jesus for the design and purpose of your marriage by fulfilling the role he's given to you. And in that way, you will experience his grace and be confirmed over and over again into who you are in him. For this reason, you, Leon, shall leave your father and mother and be united to your wife, Lynette. And the two of you, Leon and Lynette, shall become one flesh. Amen. Let us pray. Father, who would have thought such a thing? Who would have thought such a design? It is your purpose and will to bring man and woman, Leon and Lynette, together to expose them so that you might heal them and cover them and cleanse them and make them radiant and alive in you so they would know that you are yours, that they are yours as you work in them by your Spirit. And as you do so, may they give that love away over and over and find joy and delight in so doing. Delight in you and in one another, that they are free to give love away, not demanding, because they know depths of their being, that they're yours, that you've given them everything that they need for life and godliness. Help them to live out that one flesh union over and over. And when they turn away and become two or separate, help them to be quick to repent and to turn back to you and to one another and to be renewed in that oneness. It is a profound mystery, the relationship between Christ and his church. Confirm that for them and confirm it for them, even now, even today, for them and for all who are married here now and for all who want to be married and for all who encourage marriages. Lord, we trust you and we love you for this wonderful design that only you could have thought of, in Jesus' name. Leon and Lynette are now time. So would you please face each other and hold your hands. Are you ready to exchange your vows? Leon, repeat after me. Before God and these witnesses.
Before God and these witnesses.
I, Leon, take you, Lynette, to be my wife.
I, Leon, take you, Lynette, to be my wife.
With deepest joy, I receive you into my life.
With deepest joy, I receive you into my life.
That together we may be one.
That together we may be one.
As Christ loved his body, the church.
As Christ loved his body, the church.
I promise as head over you.
I promise as head over you.
To love you.
To love you.
To cherish you.
To cherish you.
To honor you.
To honor you.
And to give myself up for you.
And to give myself up for you.
I promise you my deepest love.
I promise you my deepest love.
My fullest devotion.
My fullest devotion.
My tenderest care.
My tenderest care.
Out of reverence for Christ.
Out of reverence for Christ.
I promise to live.
I promise to live.
First unto God, and then unto you.
First unto God, and then unto you.
In whatever circumstances we face.
In whatever circumstances we face.
For as long as we both shall live.
For as long as we both shall live.
I pledge to be a faithful husband to you.
I pledge to be a faithful husband to you.
This is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn vow.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Lynette, repeat after me. Before God and these witnesses.
Before God and these witnesses.
I, Lynette, take you, Leon, to be my husband.
I, Lynette, take you, Leon, to be my husband.
As you have pledged your life to me.
As you have pledged your life to me.
With deepest joy.
With deepest joy.
I come into my new life with you.
I come into my new life with you.
Making us one.
Making us one.
In faith, hope, and love.
In faith, hope, and love.
I submit myself to you.
I submit myself to you.
As to the Lord.
As to the Lord.
Out of reverence for Christ.
As out of reverence to Christ.
I promise to live first unto God and then unto you.
I promise to live first unto God and then unto you.
I promise to love you.
I promise to love you.
To help you.
To help you.
To obey you.
To obey you.
And to respect you.
And to respect you.
In whatever circumstances we face.
Whatever circumstances we face.
For as long as we both shall live.
For as long as we both shall live.
I pledge to be a faithful wife to you.
This is my solemn vow.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Well done. Leon and Lynette, as a symbol and pledge of your vows, you will now exchange rings that they may be a constant reminder of your covenant. Leon, repeat after me. Lynette, this ring I give you.
Lynette, this ring I give you.
As a symbol and pledge.
As a symbol.
And pledge.
And pledge.
Of my constant faith.
Of my constant faith.
And abiding love.
And abiding love.
And with all that I am.
And with all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor you.
I honor you.
And with this ring.
This ring.
I be well.
I be well.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Lynette, repeat after me. Leon. This ring I give you. As a symbol and pledge.
As a symbol and pledge.
Of my constant faith and abiding love.
Of my constant faith and abiding love.
And with all that I am.
And with all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor you.
I honor you.
And with this ring.
And with this ring.
I be well. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Let us pray. God our Father, we thank you for this union of Leon and Lynette. We pray that they will live the vows they have made, and that their marriage will be one that honors and glorifies you. It is only by your faithfulness and power and grace that they can do so. Remind them that they are yours through the grace of the Lord Jesus and in the fellowship of the Holy Spirit. May they continuously give away to one another that grace and patience and faithfulness that each receives from you. May they encourage one another's growth in Christ, and may each of them emulate Christ in the way you call them to, so that his aroma fills their lives and home. May your welcome, your hospitality, Lord Jesus, permeate their home. Pour out your Holy Spirit upon them, and may they remain ever faithful to you and to one another. In the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Here it comes. Leon and Lynette, having given their vows of marriage before God and these witnesses, and having confirmed and declared those vows by the giving and receiving of rings, therefore, by the authority committed to me as a minister,
of the gospel and in accordance with the laws of the state of New Jersey, which exists under God's authority, Leon and Annette, I now pronounce you to be husband and wife. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
Those whom God has joined together, let no one separate. Leon, this is your moment, my friend. You may now kiss your wife. Would you all please rise for your benediction? Now may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. May the Lord turn his face towards you and give you peace. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
Because I'm happy.
the gods of Effie Hannah. First name, Aitisha, is escorted by Bruce and Fatty, Fatty Hannah, and Aitisha Cha.
Everybody wank charm tonight.
invite Claude Hubbard to the microphone to say grace.
Good afternoon, everybody. Let's pray. Father, what a beautiful day. The sun is shining and the sky is blue. It's Palm Sunday, and it's a wedding. Leon and Lynette, this day, have chosen to become one, and they couldn't have chosen a better day for it. Because when we do look and see it's Palm Sunday, we see our Lord, their Lord, to whom they have bended their knee and given their hearts, riding in triumph into Jerusalem as the King of kings and the Lord of lords. Lord, may they both remember that they are joined together by the King, in the eyes of the King, to serve the King. And Lord, he's not like a normal king, because he didn't come to be served. He came to serve. So as we are served this wonderful food, may Lynette and Leon pause now and throughout their lives to remember that in love they have the privilege and the honor and the joy of serving each other and caring for each other. What a blessing and what a day to remember. We pray that you'll pour out your love and abundance upon them, Lord, that you may bless them and keep them and make your face to shine upon them. Be gracious unto them and show them your love. As we savor this food, will you bless this food to the healing and the nourishing of our bodies and remind us all that you are our King. If we will but listen for your voice, look for your face, bend our knee to you and give you our hearts, that we might savor an eternity with you. Bless the food to our enjoyment. Bless Leon and Lynette to each other. And bless this moment, Lord, that it may be sung about for all eternity. We ask this in Christ's name. Amen.
Amen. Hi. For those who don't know who I am, I'm Lindy, Lynette's older sister. Thank you so much for celebrating this special day with our families. This day has been a long time coming. Lynette and I have known each other for over 30 years and share fond memories of our time together. We've grown up as toddlers at our house in Queens, played the latest video game called Mario Brothers on Nintendo, helping Lynette get ready for her high school prom, burning calories playing Dance Dance Revolution or some other competitive dancing team video game, watching Lynette impressively country line dance at Colorado Cafe, visiting each other while we were away at our respective colleges, meeting celebrity chefs and eating Lynette's delicious culinary creations, celebrating her 30th birthday in Vegas, attending church retreats, faith-based conferences and concerts, Brad Paisley and Stephen Curtis Chapman most recently, vacationing with our loved ones in different parts of the globe, coaching me alongside my husband in the delivery room and I gave birth to her niece. The flower girl ran around the aisles to Jolly. And despite our personality differences and life perspective differences, our sisterly bond runs deep. For me, Lynette has been my friend, confidant, favorite shopper, and world traveling companion, next to my husband, of course, and sister for life. And it gives me great joy to share this day with her and her new husband. I remember meeting Leon for the first time over dinner roughly 4 years ago at the tiny little house in Tina, New Jersey. In trying to get to know him better, I asked him what was expecting him to share his nationality or where he was from. Instead, he answered, I'm 80% water, the rest muscle, fat, and bone. And the following Sunday, I saw my sister actually swooning over Leon's serenading her with the song Soul Sister by Train on stage after church service. Interesting, I thought. Then it occurred to me, hey, she must really like him. Hi. Then one day, started ringing at an outdoor church event and everyone started heading to their cars, I noticed Leon quickly opening an umbrella to hold over my sister and escorting her to her car. Now they're definitely heading towards Couplesville. Although those days seem so long ago, I'm amazed at how much Lynn and Leon have grown together since they first met. They've become a unit devoted towards not only loving and serving each other, but also to those around. They desire to further develop their faith in their Lord Jesus Christ, and no matter what trials or obstacles come, as is common in marriage, they are ready to tackle them head on and allow God to refine their relationship. Leon, I want to welcome you into our family and gently remind you what you already know. That it's officially birds are now to take care of my little sis. We're all counting on you to do your best. No pressure. I am making an overbearing and overprotective big sister, but it's only because I know. But it's only because I know how valuable that is and always will be to me and my mom, our mom and dad. So, if you could all raise your glasses and toast with me to the bride and groom. Oh, okay. Alright. To the bride and groom.
Here. So, guys, well, I just want to thank you guys for all these coming together and joining us for this joyous occasion. My brother, when that comes together. As Leon's old brother, I have also known him ever since he was alive. So, I just remember the first time that he told me about him just meeting up with him, getting to know her better. And the first thing that I remember is that they were going to a climbing gym together. And so I remember telling me, oh, there's this girl, Lynette, and she's screaming at me, yelling at me while I'm climbing up the wall. So, you know, literally she's driving me on the wall. I guess that's a good way to start a relationship, I'm sure, like that. But, it's an interesting parallel to just the foundation of their relationship, that it's vertical instead of just horizontal to each other, but also involving God. And I think that's the basis of a great, great relationship. That in any relationship, as says in John, 1 John, dear friends, since God loved us, so we want to love one another. And so, just want to raise our glasses once more to the beautiful bride. Cheers.
Everybody has